inner volume model for a computer system, a central processing unit, contains a number of different components. The table contains the name of a component or a description of their role in the fetch-execute cycle. Complete the table with the missing component names and descriptions. So to answer this question, I'm going to go through the process of the fetch-decode-execute cycle, which is the fetch-execute full name. I'm going to go through each of the different components of our CPU and how they work within our fetch-execute cycle. The fetch-decode-execute cycle describes how a processor runs programs that are stored in main memory. Imagine that we have a block of memory. Whenever we open up a program on our computer, that program is going to get loaded from our storage, which could be an HDD or an SSD, and it's going to get placed into our memory. We're going to load the instructions into blocks within our memory. Each of these blocks are given an address. That address is used to index or to access that memory block. Imagine that we have just loaded in a program that has 5 instructions. We've given each instruction an address on the left-hand side. Usually addresses are a lot longer and more complex. For now, we're just going to use simple addresses. The fetch decode execute cycle starts with our fetch cycle. Along with loading the program into our memory, we also load the address of the first instruction into what's called the program counter. The program counter is our first special register within the CPU. So the address of 0 is going to be loaded into the program counter. The purpose of the program counter is to store the address of the next instruction to be loaded into our CPU. In this case, the next instruction is at address number 0. Let's go ahead and write that in our answer. Holds the address of the next instruction to be processed. The program counter then sends this address to what's known as the memory address register. This is the next special register within our CPU, and this holds an address. The memory address register then sends this address over to our main memory, and the main memory reads the instruction at this particular address, so at the address of 0. This connection is what's known as our address bus. Once the memory has read this instruction, it'll pass this instruction to the memory data register. The memory data register is the next special register within our CPU. This connection is known as our data bus. The memory data register then passes the instruction to the current instruction register. The current instruction register is the next special register. This holds the current instruction that is going to be decoded and executed. Finally, the program counter is incremented by 1 so that it can load the next address on the next cycle of a fetch decode execute cycle. So we currently hold the address 0. We're now going to update it to the address of 1. On the next cycle, it will then load the instruction held at the address 1. The next component in the CPU is the control unit. The control unit is now going to decode the instruction within our current instruction register. Once it has been decoded, it will then execute the instruction. The instruction might be an arithmetic or logic instruction, in which case it'll need to use the ALU to perform this calculation. When the ALU does a calculation, it needs a place to store the result of that calculation. That is where the final register, the accumulator, is used. The accumulator stores a temporary value for the ALU to use in its calculation. Once the instruction has been executed, we go back to the beginning and we start with our program counter loading its contents into the memory address register. So the memory address register will now have the address of 1, and we continue with the rest of that cycle. Let's fill in the rest of the table. The first one asks us a description of the memory address register. The memory address register is a register that holds the address of the instruction that needs to be fetched. Let's write that down. The memory address register can also be used outside of the fetch decode execute cycle to access certain data items within our memory that aren't instructions. But for now, this description is sufficient. The next description says this is a register that is built into the ALU. It temporarily holds the results of a calculation. The register that is built in is called the accumulator. Let's write that in. The next one says this is a register that holds data or an instruction that has just been fetched from memory. The main memory sends data or instructions to the memory data register. So that is the answer here. We can also just abbreviate this to MDR, The next component is the control units. Remember that when we're writing the description for the control units, we want to mention how it operates within the fetch-execute cycle. The control unit has many other functions aside from the fetch-execute cycle. So the answer would be that it manages the execution of the instructions within our CPU. The last description says this carries addresses around the CPU. Something that carries addresses means it must be something that moves addresses from one place to another. The only thing that does that is our buses, the address bus, the data bus, and the control bus. Since they specify addresses, the answer here is going to be the address bus. And there we go. That is this question answered.